So if you're new to Mac, chances are you don't know about one of its most powerful features. It's called Spotlight. And you can bring up the Spotlight menu by clicking on the little magnifying glass that you see at the top right corner of your screen. But the keyboard shortcut is a lot more useful. Just use the Command key and Spacebar, and that brings it up. And then your hands are already on the keyboard and ready to type. Now as you can imagine, what you can do with Spotlight is search, but not just for files. You can search for other things like, say, applications or email messages. You also can get results on the internet for not only web pages, but information at Wikipedia or movie times, all sorts of things. So let's look at some examples. So let's say I want to find a file. I'll hit Command Space, and I know the file's called ostrich or something like that. It's an image of an ostrich. I'll start typing, and I don't have to finish typing the whole word. As soon as I've typed enough letters for Spotlight to narrow it down, it's going to find it. So just by typing three letters, I can see that the top result is an image, ostrich.jpg, and it even shows you kind of a grayed out version of the rest of the file name. So at this point I can stop typing and simply hit return because it shows me clearly that this image is the one selected. I can hit return and it will open the file. In this case it's opening up in preview so I could see it. Now if instead I want to actually go to the file, see where the file is located, instead of hitting return I just do Command R and it brings up the folder and with that file highlighted. So I can go to the file as well as open it. Now notice I get a whole bunch of other results. I've got a dictionary definition, I've got a map location, some suggested websites. You're going to get a whole bunch of things. You can scroll down and see them. You can also use the arrow keys to go through them. So if you wanted to bring up a dictionary definition, you could just go over that, hit return, and it would open up a dictionary. So it brings up a lot of different things. The way you control what it brings up is if you go to System Preferences and then go to Spotlight, and you can see in search results, these are all the different types of search results that will come up. So you can turn some of them off. For instance, if you don't want it to find mail messages when you use Spotlight, you can turn that off. If you don't want it to do things like show you spreadsheets or show you the items in System Preferences, you can turn all these on and off. You can also turn off Spotlight suggestions, which are things like movie times and other items like that. So you can really customize what it shows. Now perhaps one of the most powerful things that Spotlight can do for you is find applications. So for instance, say you want to launch an app and it's not in your dock, like the calculator app. How would you get to it? Well, you would have to open up a Finder window, navigate to the Applications folder, look for the calculator app, and double click it. Or you can run Launchpad and search for a calculator and all of that. But instead you can just use Spotlight. Command space, start typing the name of the app, and you could see even just typing four characters narrows it down for the top hit to be the app calculator. And now I can hit return and the calculator app comes up. Spotlight can also do some special things. For instance, you can use it as a calculator. Just type in a simple math formula and it will come up with an answer. You can even type a more complex math formula and you get the result for that as well. So in a way it's a better calculator than the calculator. You can also use it for unit conversions. So you could say 4 pints and it gives you liters. 7 kilometers gives you miles, that kind of thing. Even currency conversions work for it. So I can see it's $7 in euros, pounds, yen, etc. And there are a lot of other things that the Spotlight menu can do for you. I'll just leave you with one last one. If you type in weather, you can get your local weather forecast.